And we're rolling.
Hello, everybody. Welcome back to Glam Beauty Life. I am your co-host, Danielle of Danielle D Beauty, and
I am Vivian Winter of Vivian Winter and Amplified Glamour Roll Spa. Nice to see you guys again this week.
Welcome back. So much has happened in 1 week.
Yes. Oh my gosh.
First of all, where do we start?
Let's see. Let's just talk about your week. Did you do anything this week or weekend or anything pretty fun?
Pretty much, I've been planning for my makeup classes coming up this Saturday.
Yes. Okay. Yeah.
So I'm excited about that. I got a couple women that are going to come. I like to keep it a small group, you know, like I said last week, so people can get it. But yeah, so I'm really excited. Been planning about that. And so yeah, and then I start teaching in my high school today. So I can't wait to see my babies to squeeze their little cheeks.
Yes. And tell them what you teach and where you teach, because some of them may be familiar or want to join.
Yeah, so this is my 7th year teaching at Flowers High School. I teach makeup there as an extracurricular activity for the drama team. This year we'll be doing a rendition of the Motown play that you see on Broadway. So we're really excited about that. We got the Temptations, we got the Four Tops, we got Diana Ross.
Yeah.
Yeah, so it's going to be really nice.
I love that. Let's see, what else have I done? Okay, yeah, so this weekend I did inaugural makeup.
Oh my gosh, how was that?
That was really good for the official inaugural parade, and then also the ball was awesome. Mm-hmm. Some clients and a client referral, so shout out to Heather for that.
Nice.
Let's see what else. I had also another shoot with Dominique Broadway. I shot with Ray Whitney Photography, and one of our favorite clients, Dominique Broadway, she runs Finances Demystified. So that's her company in which she teaches millennials how to actually gain wealth and throughout life. She's awesome. She's a financial planner, and she's amazing. She does a lot on social media too, and that's Dominique Broadway, so look out for her.
Nice.
And we took also, so she did branding. She also did like family photos with mom and sisters. That was really cool because I've known her forever, and it was nice to meet her family.
Awesome. Did you do their makeup also?
Yeah, mom and mom, sister Dominique. Yeah, it was really good. Yeah. So actually, I posted pictures on Instagram and on Facebook last week. So yeah, you guys go check it out and see what you think this past weekend. What about our try tonight? Should we go ahead and get right into it?
Let's get right on into it. So this year. So this week we're going to do try or deny natural hair edition. So
yes.
If you guys know, the natural hair is a phenomenon now. Like, it's been for the past, 11 years?
Yeah.
It's really starting to really pop, and everyone is going natural. So I'm natural. I've been natural for 11 years, and Vivian is natural as well. So we're going to give you our try or deny it hair products.
Yes.
So my first try it is a holy grail for me.
Okay.
It's an oldie but goodie. It's Carol's Daughter Mimosa Hair Honey. I use it for myself.
Yes.
My son uses it. I use it for my nephew because he has like a little brush and I braid his hair. So yeah, I love the Carol's Daughter Mimosa Hair Honey. It's really lightweight. It smells awesome.
So when we first moved here from Kentucky, there weren't a lot of like natural products for girls in Kentucky.
Yeah.
When we first moved here, I got introduced to Carol's Daughter. That was around 2002. Here from Kentucky. And so it was interesting because Mimosa Hair Honey was one of the first products I tried, and I love that. That like that for me like made me like the line. And then I guess I can actually roll into mine, because then I tried the hair milk, which I loved.
Still
so I love the hair milk from them as well. Mm-hmm. What's your next one? You got another one maybe?
So another holy grail. So you know, as natural girls, when we do our ponytails, and Vivian does her buns all the time. Like, it's all about making sure your edges are slick and snatched, okay?
Yeah.
So, I love the olive oil
gel.
The olive oil gel.
It's in the green.
It's in the green jar, the green top. Listen, if you see it, get it. It's usually like a big jar for like less than $6.
$6 at CVS, and it's literally the hugest thing ever.
I've seen it in CVS. I've seen it in
Walmart. It's actually cheaper in Walmart, too. It's really good, yeah.
And I've seen it in Sally's, too. So it's pretty much everywhere. It's the Eco-Style,
the Eco-Style. But they also have an argan oil one, and then they also have an olive oil one. The argan oil is like red and gold. That for me, again, everyone's hair is different. It didn't slick my hair down and it didn't keep my edges laid. Yeah. But the olive oil one, olive oil one was amazing. So
get your life. It's so bomb.
Okay, so let's move on. Maybe I'm going to talk about something skin that's one of my tries that everyone should have. So doesn't have to be the Clarisonic, but any motorized facial brush. Yeah. I use my cleanser, my scrub with this. I literally did it this morning. I do it 3 times a week. Basically, it's an oscillating brush. So the brush head bristles, they go different ways. And what that means is it's going to get down into the skin. It's going to really clean your pores. It's going to brighten your skin. It's going to help with any texture, hyperpigmentation, you name it. It's really going to help. Good for oily skin, good for dry skin, good for normal skin, good for everyone.
Yeah.
But every company makes some oil of Olay. I've seen a couple companies in Ulta that have different ones. But an oscillating face brush, guys, get it. It will change your life, especially if you wear makeup, and even if you don't as we age.
Yeah.
Exfoliation, again, we talked about, is like the biggest anti-aging. So this just really helps. So with your cleanser and scrub 3 times a week, any face brush, and I'm going to definitely tell you to go out and get it.
Yes.
For sure.
So for my deny it, I have a deny it.
Okay.
Well, yeah. Wait, I have a really quick try it. So I love Ross and I love Marshall.
Me too.
Little places.
Yeah.
If you ever go there, you guys, the first place I stop is in the little makeup section, little cosmetics section.
Okay.
You always find little trinkets, little cute little things.
Yes.
So I ran across, well, actually someone gave me this, but I get them all the time, and it's like a little spongy thingy. It's like a beauty blender, but it's a little more dense.
Show them how like flat it is too, because it's like super flat right
there. Yeah. So
which makes it easy to literally lay and get in those areas that
I think this would be good for like to do concealer, but as far as foundation, I feel like it would pick up too much product and you will waste product.
Yeah.
So I think it's good for blending, but I don't think it's good for actually applying your foundation. You want to stick with either an Alcone wedge sponge or a beauty blender, or Real Techniques has a beauty blender as well that people love. I haven't tried it yet, but it's an orange beauty blender as well. So you guys try those instead of trying to apply foundation with the hard sponges, because you're going to be doing too much work.
Yeah.
It's going to give you
medium to full coverage. Again, yeah. As an esthetician, I would never recommend sponges. What happens is we transfer bacteria from the makeup back to our face, back to the makeup, back to our face. And that's where we get a lot of that breaking out. We get, texture on the skin. Skin just really doesn't like when that happens.
Yeah.
So what I would also suggest is using a foundation brush, you know, but whether it be a buffer brush, something that's long and flat to apply your foundation.
Yeah.
If you use the long and flat ones, those are going to be about medium coverage. If you use something that's a buffer brush, it's going to, and if it's very dense, meaning it's hard when you hit it on the top, that's going to give you full coverage, which is similar to what that really dense sponge is going to give you.
Absolutely.
So unless you're looking for that, that was a deny it too. Yeah.
It kind of was in between for me.
Okay. I'd say that.
And then real quick, another deny for natural hair. So I know a lot of women, natural hair women, you want to do your twist out, you want to do your wash and go, and you have this shrinkage. Well, Dark and Lovely has a system where it's an anti-reversion system, meaning your hair won't revert back as quickly.
Yeah.
And it's pretty much a lotion that you put on your hair before you blow dry it out, before you apply your styling product. It's supposed to help with shrinkage. Listen, I had a really bad breakage at the top of my hair
from
that stuff. So for me, it did not work. So for me, it's a deny.
Okay, cool. And that was, again, the Dark and Lovely 6-week anti-reversion system. Deny it. All right, moving along. So I have been seeing a lot of memes lately, and a lot of women just in my feed, and just kind of a lot of my single girls, a lot of my divorced, widowed, any of that kind of thing, that are really wondering where this class of guy has gone. The guy that was chivalrous, the one that would take you out on dates, the one that would open the door, come ring the doorbell, not just beep and say, you know, or call and say, I'm outside. Someone that's really going to come and kind of be chivalrous and a gentleman to you and kind of court you in a way. What do you think? What's up with that?
I just don't know. I just don't know. One thing I have learned is that you have to attract the guy that you want.
Yeah, definitely.
You have
to intentionally like decide what you will and what you won't deal
exactly,
with.
Exactly, like,
you know, what's a deal breaker, what's not.
Exactly. I have a friend who had she had a situation where she met this guy and she felt like she was getting along with him. They had only been talking like maybe 2 days.
Okay.
And so then he just started talking about sex all the time. Right?
Oh, okay.
So she's like, oh, well, I'm not really looking to have sex with you.
Yeah, I just kind of want to get to know you.
He's like, oh, well, that's not going to last long. I'm like,
well, really? Good. I'm glad you told me because I'm out. First of all, I'm married now, but what I won't do, and my husband will tell you.
My thing is, if you can't respect the woman's decision, just.
And you know what? To be honest, for me, there's a level of respect for guys like that, because even when I was dating, I would almost always rather the guy that would just keep it real and be like, look, this is what it is. Like, you can deal with it or not.
Yeah.
But what I don't like is that whole sneaking around. Like, just be honest. If you this player, be a player. Don't be a player and then be a coward.
Right.
And then you can't do both. If you dating women, say you dating them.
Yeah.
Open your mouth and be honest and have mature conversation.
Absolutely.
The problem is these guys want to like be like all this player, but they're not mature enough to even open their mouth and say it. Where I'll be like, look, I have friends. Like, it's cool. Just let me know if you don't want to. But
right.
I'd love to get to know you. But that's up to you. Let me know. Put it in their hands and leave it alone.
I don't know.
But again, I could just only hope. I know when we first moved here, my mom was saying that because like in we had never really lived in a place where the out count of men to women, the ratio was just so different. Like,
yeah.
I think here you have like 6 men to 1, six ladies to 1 man.
Yeah.
And so you have this very like fight or flight, like shark eat shark, like crabs in a barrel situation where some women will settle. They will, you know, feel like, well, I don't know. I got to lock them down because I know somebody else will.
Right.
And it's sad, you know what I mean? But that's when it comes back to like loving yourself too. So
absolutely.
Anyway, I hope for the best. I hope these guys, and they're out there. Like, trust me, they're out there. I think sometimes we get so comfortable we never look outside of our comfort zone. I always tell people, go to different restaurants, go to different neighborhoods, go to places where you're not used to hanging out. Like, you know, if you usually go to Starbucks in Lanham, go to Starbucks in Alexandria, meet a different type of person, and yeah. I guarantee you they're out there. We just got to make sure that we're in the right places to receive it,
I agree.
And that we are right to receive it.
I think
that's most important
you.
Than anything. So, yeah. With that being said, let's
great
see.
Advice, Viv. Great advice.
Yeah, I just think, you know, I'm very obviously passionate about it, but I love my girl, so keep fighting, don't ever settle, and he will come. I promise you that. I know people say that, but I promise you he will come, and he'll come when you're not ready for him, too.
Yeah, you least expect it.
So let's talk about the new edition movie that you
oh my yeah, God.
Auditioned on Hollywood Walk of Fame.
So I have to go and make sure I have my snacks and my drinks and stuff ready for tonight because it is a big deal.
Yeah, I'm excited.
I grew up on New Edition. That was like the only group that I would like go crazy about. I remember my aunt coming to pick me up from school and I had a surprise and we ended up like in Baltimore at a New Edition concert.
Yeah.
Oh my God, this is back when they were like going down a sliding board. Like this was like early Candy Girl days, okay? Like it was so, oh my, I was so excited for this movie.
Yes, I
so,
am too.
So wait.
Who's my favorite?
Who's your favorite?
I knew you were going to ask that. I don't know why.
It better not be my favorite because we're going to fight.
Okay, my favorite was Ronnie DeVoe.
No! No! No!
I still love
him. No! No! Everybody knows that Ronnie. Ronnie's mine. Whatever, Viv.
I'm sorry.
No!
Tell
no.
me why he was so cute back in the day.
No!
Tell me why he was so cute back in the day.
Yeah, he definitely was.
See, that's why you're always
doing.
Yes,
he's
girl.
Still- Yo.
Because I used to love, like, the KC type, like, the whole, like, thuggish, ruggish,
Ronnie
but not really, but, like...
Ronnie bought the swag. You hear me?
Yes.
You don't hear me, though. Ronnie, he still got swag.
Mm-hmm.
Y'all follow Ronnie on Instagram because you would get your life with his swag still.
Yes.
But anyway...
So, you know I'm a Southern Bama, but that's how I feel about Silk the Shocker. It just makes me think, like... Back in the day! First of all, don't judge me because y'all already know I'm from the South, so you know we got down with Hot Boys, Cash Money, 504 Boys. It wasn't nothing like...
Wait, Cash Money,
not to throw it back, but yeah, that's the way I feel. But anyway, yeah, I love Ronnie DeVoe. So
yeah, me too. So it comes on tonight at 9:00 on BET. You guys, please watch this movie. Support our boys. Support our guys.
Yeah, definitely.
Like I think he's our generation's temptation.
Yeah,
you know
no,
mean?
Definitely.
And everyone's still together, which I really love.
Yeah,
me
too.
I can't wait. I can't wait to see the story and see you know what they went through and stuff.
All right, so we had actually a question come in. Dear Glam Beauty Life host, how do I convince my mother-in-law to share her secret recipes? My husband doesn't enjoy my cooking, and I want him to be happy by recreating his mom's popular meals. Help, oh please.
Oh, poor baby.
I know. All right, so, I mean, every person
that you take this
every person's relationship is different, you know, with their mother-in-law. I think it depends on the relationship. I think if you guys have a warm relationship,
yeah.
Then just say, hey, you know how much I admire your cooking, and Dominic really loves your lasagna. Can you please give me the recipe? Because
yes.
I'd love to be able to make it
or,
like you.
Or
if you guys aren't tight,
yeah.
Then I would say something like, you know, I really, again, same thing, I really admire your cooking. I just really am trying to learn how to cook, you know that. And just don't make it a big deal. Just ask her. Same thing. Like, I think people make it a big deal, but it doesn't have to be a big deal.
Right.
You know, I don't know what you say.
I agree. Or you could try that. Or if you're not the type, if you're not the verbal person.
Yeah, that's real.
I'm not really that verbal. Yeah. I'll sneak in the kitchen and be like, oh, Mama Lucy, how you make that? And just kind of look over her shoulder and kind of taking your mental notes.
Yeah, what she's
just
putting it in,
but,
how much.
But do it to where it's not like you're trying to steal her recipes. It's like you're complimenting her, but at the same time, you're taking notes.
And see, from the South, it's weird because we never steal recipes. I never even would think that anybody would think it is stealing recipes because we love to share recipes. It's about, like, food is love.
Yeah.
So, like, if you're sharing recipes with people, no matter how much you love or hate them, it's such a warm gesture. You
it's
know
not
what I mean?
It's not like that in D.C.
Okay.
No, it's not.
People will say you're stealing their recipe. What
the secret barbecue recipe, and if my family is watching, that's in my family. No one shares that.
Okay, first of all, I'm all for licensing and making money off of it. That's what I'm all for. I'm all for like selling it. But just like being competition, say, girl, you can't make barbecue sauce. Like, friend, it's barbecue sauce.
Listen,
unless you're making money off of it, you got that thing trademarked. Hush your mouth, okay? Because you already talking.
Listen,
and ain't got nothing trademarked.
It's not me though.
Nothing.
It's the family. It's not me. I'm just going by what I see.
Yeah.
There's a secret barbecue recipe. There's a secret fried chicken recipe. Yeah. There's a secret greens recipe. And there's a secret macaroni and cheese recipe. Oh, and sweet potatoes pie.
Yeah.
In my family.
Yeah.
That we don't share with anybody.
Yeah.
But I'll share with you, Vivian.
Okay, and I'll share ours with you, too, because
okay, cool.
You know we got them, too.
Yeah, because Vivian always has a lover.
So what we do usually, like, we kind of, like, have our makeup half done. She comes over every morning, and we kind of have our makeup half done, and we just have, like, we eat
early.
Yeah, literally, we eat together, and then we start filming. So that's kind of what we do.
We always,
so,
We always get together and we love each other before we actually get started.
Yeah. So believe by the time we see you guys, we've been like laughing and talking this whole time.
I know.
That's like the whole thing. Alrighty, so do something today that encourages you to love yourself in the same way that others love and see you. You are worth it.
You are worth it. And always treat people how you want to be treated. Yes. Because that's how it all just goes.
Good karma, good juju, good positive vibes.
Yeah, everywhere. Like what you give out is what you should give back. Yeah, absolutely. If you give out drama, guess what? Drama's going to come and bite you.
Yeah, don't you hate the people that are like, oh my God, like I just got to step away from the drama. Like drama just follows me. No, you attract drama. Like
you are drama
doesn't follow you. You attract drama. You are drama because they see that in you.
Absolutely.
Like to be honest with you.
Yes.
Yeah. So anyway, put out what you want to receive, guys, and you will receive it. We love you so much. We look forward to next week. Drop any questions below, glambeautylife@gmail.com, if you want to, you know, do an anonymous questions. Other than that, tell us in the comments below what you guys would like to see, what you have coming up, if you guys would like, you know, a certain makeup lesson or anything with the two of us. Just let us know, guys. We're open. Just communicate with us.
Yeah.
We can't wait to hear from you soon.
And in between shows, if you want to kind of take a peek and see what we're doing on our Instagram pages, you can follow Vivian at Vivian Winter. That's Winter with the Y.
Yes.
And then you can follow me at Danielle D. Beauty on all social media. It's the same for Vivian also.
Yes, absolutely.
So that's it for today, right?
Love you guys. All right. Love you, Danielle.
Thank you for coming through. Love you.
Bye.
Bye, guys. All right.